This is the Reuleaux triangle bearing, a mechanism which takes advantage of the unique properties found in objects of constant width. But it took a lot of experimentation to get this thing to work. Let's get started. How's it going, guys? Angus here from Maker's Muse. So last year I became obsessed with solids of constant width. These are curious looking forms which, when rolled under a flat plane, act like spheres or balls. Their unique geometry maintains a constant distance from top to bottom, no matter what orientation they're in, which made me ponder if a bearing of some kind could be possible using them. My first attempt was a basic roller bearing with 2D forms packed around it, and I concluded that although these objects do maintain a constant width, their center point actually changes throughout the rotation, which results in the shapes either falling out due to insufficient support or colliding with each other, resulting in more of a sliding motion than true rotational movement that you'd see in a normal bearing. That video went on to get loads of hits, and many of you guys had really neat ideas on how this could be resolved to make a truly functional Reuleaux triangle bearing. So I got back to work. The first and by far most popular suggestion was to implement what's known as a cage, which is a supporting structure which spaces the balls in a regular ball bearing, allowing them to rotate freely but keeping them separated and not rubbing up against one another. The crazy thing about shapes of constant width though is they do not trace a circular path as they rotate, but instead, in the case of the Reuleaux triangle, trace a square. And it's this property which sees them used in special square hole drilling jigs. So therefore the cage has to look like this. This cage looks visually stunning and I had really high hopes. But sadly, like before, the shapes tended to slide more rather than roll. They do roll occasionally, but not constantly. And their center of mass means that the force of getting past each sharp angle was much harder than simply just sliding, and they also have to revolve up against this edge of the bearing cage itself, which makes it even harder to rotate. I had a go at extending the faces up to mate with the 45 degree bearing overhangs in an attempt to create more surface contact and thus more friction, but in the end, not really. This was not a route that was working as well as I wanted. So, another suggestion was the idea of constraining each shape with an additional ring. However, because the center point changes during rotation, it can't just be fixed to a single point, it actually in fact needs to be a slot. So in this version, the center point of the objects are loosely fixed to the ring with an M6 screw tapped into the plastic. This allows them to smoothly rotate as well as move up and down, but still be constrained at 120 degrees apart from each other, because in this case I'm using three shapes. Theoretically, if every surface mated perfectly and we didn't have this annoying real-world thing called tolerance to deal with, I see no reason why this shouldn't work really well. But alas, more sliding. It almost works, but it's not quite good enough. So I thought to myself, what if I could just give these shapes a tiny bit more friction to work with? I went ahead and designed a modified version which uses a semi-flex insert, which was printed on my modified Cocoon Create with the Flexion extruder. The rest of these parts, by the way, were printed on the Prusa Mark III, mostly in filamentum, vertical vertigo gray, and gold happens PLA. Also, if you're wondering how I achieved this surface effect, I simply turned the top or bottom layers off in Slicer Prusa Edition and used the cubic infill. Looks pretty swanky, hey? But by this point, I was growing frustrated with just how hard it was to rotate the shapes past each curve. So I caved and went about modifying the shape themselves, the Reuleaux triangle, to be ever so slightly rounded on the corners. Though it turns out creating a rounded Reuleaux triangle isn't a super trivial exercise. You need to pay close attention to the tangential relations of each part to ensure it's truly a shape of constant width and not an almost but not quite shape that almost works but doesn't have a true constant width around the whole object. And this was the final form, a slightly rounded shape with a thin semi-flex insert to provide just a little bit more traction to encourage rotation. You have no idea how overjoyed I was when I tested this out and it worked. It works so well, exactly how I envisioned it when I first attempted this ridiculous concept all those months ago. It's satisfying to turn and doesn't get caught up, and it always rolls, it doesn't slide. Although, interestingly, the rubber inserts tend to migrate slowly around the shape, which is something I'll have to investigate later. But for now, it works. So what do you do with it? Well, how about hooking it up to a motor? So there you have it, guys, a working Reuleaux triangle bearing turned into a kind of kinetic sculpture. And while the use of solids of constant width has pretty much no advantage over circles or spheres in an actual bearing that I can see, it definitely looks incredible while in motion. I'd like to say that this is the end of my mad descent into these forms, but honestly, I don't think I'm quite done yet. I've got a few more wacky ideas to test out in future, and it is my aim to empower your creativity through technology. And if you would like to join me, I'd love for you to subscribe. Also, a huge thanks to my Patreon supporters for making all of this possible. There was some pretty crazy late nights involved in getting this project done, including this really clever idea that I thought would work at like 2 a.m. at night. I don't know what I was thinking. And your generous support keeps the channel going. You can expect to find the files for the final version and instructions posted up shortly there on Patreon. But for now, thanks for watching, guys. Catch you later. In the latter half of the 20th century, a man has sent rockets into deep space. He has placed satellites into orbit.